Now, tenses are divided into three parts. All of us are aware about that: present, past, and future. And further, they are divided into four forms. Let me explain you those forms. The simple form of present tense is simple present. Continuous form is present continuous form. Perfect form is present perfect tense. Perfect continuous form is present perfect continuous tense. Same goes with the past tense. First of all, it is simple past. Then we have past continuous tense. Then we have past perfect tense, followed by past perfect continuous tense. Future, same like past and present. Simple future tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, future perfect continuous tense. This is all about the tense. Now let's talk about tenses and their form used. Present tense, in simple present tense, the form used is first form of verb. Present continuous, when it is a present continuous tense, the form used is am, are, plus first form of verb with ing. Present perfect tense, the form used is has, have, plus third form of verb. In the present perfect continuous form, we have has, been, have been, plus first form of verb, plus ing, plus since and for. Now we have past tense. In simple past tense, the form used is second form of verb. Past continuous, was, were, plus first form of verb plus ing. Past perfect tense is had plus third form of the verb. Past perfect continuous tense, had been, plus first form of verb plus ing, plus since or for. Future tense. Future tense, simple future tense, shall, will, plus first form of verb. Future continuous tense, will, shall, plus be, plus first form of verb plus ing. In future perfect tense, we have shall, will, have, plus third form of verb. Future perfect continuous, we have shall, will, plus have been, plus first form of verb plus ing, plus since or for. This was all about tenses and their form used. Now, simple present tense is used to express habitual actions, general truth, in vivid narrative. Example of habitual actions. To express a habitual action, for example, my son studies daily. Every night my father tells me a story. In example first, habit is studying, and where daily means present. In example 2, habit is telling a story, where every night again means present. I hope now you have understood habitual actions. Now, example of general truth. The earth moves round the sun. The sun rises in the east. These two examples are the examples of general truth or universal truth. From these examples, you must be clear that general truth falls under the category of simple present tense. Vivid narrative includes to express a situation or a fact that is permanent, as the capital of India is New Delhi. My school building faces north. Present continuous tense. Action that is happening at the time of speaking is present continuous tense. For example, she is dancing or Ram is playing. These above mentioned examples are still in progress. Therefore, they are examples of present continuous tense. In present continuous tense, first form of verb along with ing is used. For example, dance plus ing is equal to dancing. Play plus ing is equal to playing. Now, let's move to present perfect tense. Present perfect tense is recently completed action, indefinite time in the past, to describe a past event, to express an action having taken place in the past and is still in progress. Now, I'll give you the example of recently completed action. I have just received a letter. She has arrived 2 minutes ago. In the above examples, you can see that the actions that has been recently completed, like the letter has just arrived or she has arrived 2 minutes ago, just and 2 minutes tell that action has just been completed. Now, let's talk about indefinite time in the past. I have watered the plants. He has sent a message. To describe an action which has just occurred, but the time is not given, as to the time when the action has occurred. The plants are watered, but at what time isn't mentioned. Or message has been sent, but again time isn't mentioned. I hope you are clear with one more point of present perfect tense. Now let's move to describe a past event. Priya has been to Shimla twice. I have seen this film. Present perfect tense contains a very important category, that is to describe a past event. To be more specific, it describes a past event having some connection with the present. To express an action having taken place in the past and in still progress. Like, we have lived here for 10 years. He is studying in this school from 5th standards. Last feature of present perfect tense is to express an action having taken place in the past and continuing in the present. As the example states, we have lived here for 10 years. For the last 10 years, they have been living here. That is past and is still living. This is present. Studying since 5th standard, past, and still studying is present. Present perfect continuous tense. To express an action which began in the past and still going on the time is known. To express an action which began in the past and is still continuing but the time is unknown. To express an action in a sentence which begins with for how long or since when. To express an action which began in the past and is still going on. She has been dancing since afternoon. I have been living here for last 2 years. Since and for are used with perfect tenses. Since is used when you exactly know what point of time the incident occurred. As in the first example, you can see that incident occurred in the afternoon. And as the time is known when incident is occurred, since is used. For is used when exact time of the incident occur is not known. In the second example, it is said that the person is living here for the last 2 years, but from which year he lives, that has not been specified. In such a situation, for is used. To express an action which began in the past and still continuing. Jack's clothes are dirty because he has been playing football. Present perfect continuous tense is used to express an action which began in the past and is still going on. In the above example, you can see that the work began in the past and is still going on in present. Like, Jack started playing football in the past and is still playing. That is, he has continued the task in the present also. Now, to express an action in a sentence which begins with for how long and since when. Since when you have started working, for how long you have been working in this company. In the present perfect continuous tense, for how long and since when are used. Simple past tense. Action completed in the past. Past habits, to express an action which occupied a period of time in the past but has ended now. Action completed in the past. I met an old woman. We went to Delhi last year. From the examples, one can easily make out that one of the features of simple past tense is to express an action completed in the past with the reference to the time of speaking. Past habits. When he was young, he went for morning walk daily. She visited the market to purchase fruits. From the examples, one can make out that a simple past tense is used to express a habitual or regular action in the past. To express an action which occupied a period of time in the past but has ended now. Simple past tense is also used to express an action which occupied a period of time in the past but has ended now. He worked for 2 hours, has finished working. I stayed in Delhi for 10 years, not staying now. Let's have a look on past continuous tense. Asha was watching TV. The boy was running. From the mentioned examples, it is very clear that the past continuous tense is used to describe an action that was in progress at a point of time but is over now. I was sleeping when that man arrived. She was studying when the doorbell rang. Past continuous tense is also used to describe an action that was in progress when another action took place. For example, mother was watching television while his father was reading newspaper. The boys were singing and the girls were dancing. One of the major use of past continuous tense as seen in the examples is to describe two actions going on at the same time in the past. Now, let's have a look on past perfect tense. Past perfect tense is used to express an action completed in the past with the words already, before, never, even, still, etc. Past perfect tense is also used to describe an action which was completed before another action took place in the past. For example, the patient had died before the doctor arrived. They had cleaned the room when the guest came. Now, let's have a look on past perfect continuous tense. We had been studying for 2 hours when you came. The cook had been cooking since morning. In the examples, you can see that the past perfect continuous tense is used to describe an action which continued in the past for a given period of time. Now, let's have a look on simple future tense. They will get married next month. I shall go to the market in the evening. There is no specific way to express future tense. The future tense can be expressed in many ways by using shall, will, and by using going to. Shall is normally used with I. As you can see in the example, I shall go to the market. Shall is used with I and going to is used to express future actions which have been decided before or which are going to take place in near future. For example, I am going to be a doctor one day or I am going to a movie tonight. Future continuous tense. This tense is used to talk about actions which will be in progress at a time in the future. For example, I suppose it will be raining once we get out. At 5 p.m. on Monday, I will be working. Let's talk about future perfect tense. Future perfect tense is used to describe an action that will be completed at the some point of time in the future. It is now 6 a.m. I shall have reached school by 8:30 a.m. I shall have finished this project by the end of this month. This tense indicates an action that will be completed before a certain time or another action in the future. This tense is often associated with the preposition by. There is also one more feature of this tense, that is, it is also used to indicate duration up to a time in future. For example, when I will leave the school next year, I shall have studied here for 12 years. On January 22nd, we shall have married for 8 years. Future perfect continuous tense. Priya will have been practicing her speech for 10 days. The baby will have been sleeping for 2 hours. This tense is used to describe an action that will be in progress even after a given point of time in future. By the time you will come back, we shall have worked for 2 hours. The future perfect continuous tense is used to express the duration of an action up to a certain time in future. By the end of this year, he will have been in army for 20 years. It is also used when the action is expressed as a continuous action. This was all about the tense.